can't put students first if you put teachers last. The crowd of red showed up by the thousands to make sure those in the state house could hear them loud and clear.
Rise up, ISTA!
Educators from more than 145 districts across the state say kids notice that teachers are being overworked and underpaid.
I had a young sixth grader come up to me and say, "Mr. Jones, something's wrong. You don't look the same today."
You can see that when teachers aren't made a priority, the kids can see that we don't really care about their education and that they aren't a priority.
Indiana ranks 51st in the country for salary growth in education. According to Indiana State Teachers Association President Keith Gamble, the Hoosier State has the lowest pay in the region.
We can no longer continue down this path. To the legislators in the State House today, we say, pencils down, your time is up!
The vice president of the National Education Association joined Indiana teachers for the rally today.
You understand the importance and the power of your collective voices joining together and saying enough.
And we're here for the kids and for ourselves.
Although teachers say there are many issues, there are three main items on their agenda this session, including teacher compensation, issues with iLearn and how it impacts teacher evaluations, and repealing externship requirements for teachers renewing their license.
They have to be lifelong learners, and if they've already lost that spark at, 10, 11, 12 years old, what good is it going to be for the future of our state?
Educators say they'll do whatever it takes.
We must rise up and support public education.
Because they say the kids rely on it.
Indiana says they're a state that works, but if we don't invest in our education now, we're not going to be a state that works in the near future.
In Indianapolis, Melissa Crash, Fox 59 News.
Melissa, thanks. State lawmakers are also responding to today's